Good morning, students. In the last class, we discussed about the conductors and insulators. Today, we can see some uses of conductors and insulators. Now, when we talk about uses of conductors, we can see that the electrical appliances that are made, they all are good conductors of electricity. Otherwise, insulators are also very useful to us, because in order to handle some electrical appliances, we need a covering which is made of insulating material. Like there are some electric tools like screwdriver, tester, pliers, these all are covered with an insulating material so that they can easily be handled without receiving any electric shock. So these insulating materials can be either of plastic or some other hard materials, hard insulating materials. They do not allow the current to pass through it, and as a result we are able to handle it without receiving any electric shock. So we have so many uses for insulating materials or an insulators. Let us now move to a very important discussion, which is resistance. Now, students, we know that different metals have different conductivity. That is, different metals allow different amounts of current to flow through it. You know the reason why. The reason is because all these metals offer different resistance, so that equal amount of current is not passed through it. So resistance is that property of a conductor due to which it opposes the flow of the current. It is because of differences in opposing the flow of the current we find conductors making the current flow by different amounts. For example, silver is considered to be the best conductor of electricity because it offers the least resistance. Similarly, iron also conducts electricity, but the amount of current flowing through the iron is not so large because it offers large resistance. So more is the resistance of a conductor, less will be the current flowing through it. We have this about the resistance. Let us now move to another topic which is yet very important, which is circuit in series and parallel. That is, in the series or in the circuit, how can we connect the appliances? There are two ways of connecting the appliances. One is called the series connection and the other is called parallel connection. So let us try to understand this. Circuit in series and connection, parallel. Let us see what is series connection first. We will be coming to series connection. And in series connection, the appliances to be used are always connected in the same wire. For example, let us see how to connect the appliance in series. Suppose we have the two appliances like bulb and fan to connect to give series connection. Let us see, this is the circuit we have with bulb, not bulb, with the battery, the wire, and say we have this the wire where we are going to connect this fan and bulb in series. So to give connection to these appliances in series, we will be cutting the wire in two different places. You can see the same wire has been cut, has been broken in two different places, and we are connecting fan and the bulb here. So if the connection is made in the same wire, then it is the series connection. But series connection has got many disadvantages. Let us see all these disadvantages also one by one. First is that the appliances connected in series will work simultaneously, that is, cannot be worked individually. That means all the appliances connected in series cannot be given a separate switch. So as a result, if one fan or any of the appliances goes out of the order, they get damaged due to any reason, it will also be affecting the other appliance. Say here, if the fan does not work, has gone out of order, it will also affect the bulb, and as a result the bulb will also not be glowing. Or any other appliances are connected, they will also not work properly due to the passage of the current altogether has stopped. And third disadvantage is that these appliances are not going to receive the same voltage. One may receive a very high voltage, the other will be receiving low voltage. That is, the voltage supply will get divided. As a result, they will not be getting the same voltage, so they will not be working with the same efficiency. We have this as the major disadvantage of connecting the appliances in series. Let us now see how to give connection to the same appliances in parallel. In a parallel connection, we will be giving different wires to all the appliances. For example, again we can take this as the electric circuit. With this wire, we have connected the fan. Now instead of connecting bulb in the same wire, we will be taking another wire in the same circuit where the bulb is connected. So this is called the parallel connection and has got many advantages. Now this time we can see that all the appliances connected in parallel can work individually, and different switches can be given to each of the appliances. You might have seen these the different appliances at your home also, with different switches in it, which can be handled independently. Second is that if one appliance goes out of order, it is not going to affect the other appliance. It will keep on working with the same intensity. And third is that all will be getting equal voltage, same voltage. So all are going to work with the same efficiency due to the same amount of voltage received by them. So these are the advantages we have for the parallel connection. In all the houses, it is this connection that is used. I hope it is clear. So all these advantages of parallel connection and disadvantages of series connections are very important. So you should learn all these advantages and disadvantages. Thank you.